and welcome to Centurion's Corner. And today we have another box all the way over from China, from AliExpress, and we have some more clones as well. And as you can see from the thumbnail, I think they are the 442nd Battalion. And yeah, kind of looking forward to these. When these come out, they look pretty cool because they released a whole squad. I think these ones were just before the Wolf Pack as well, so we're still catching up over time. So we'll get this open. So they come in a standard little bag like this, and inside they are fully jam-packed in their nice little box. So we take this part off here, and not looking too bad. No dings or anything on there, which is pretty good, considering it's come over there. It's taken a little while to come over. Normally these come in about 2 weeks, but these are taken probably just a little bit longer, just over the 2 week mark, but I think it's because they just had their new year as well. So yeah, taking these out, guys, out. So they're covered in bubble wrap on the inside here. Get rid of the box and then cut this open like so. This time normally I order in pairs, but this time I actually ordered all four. There was one extra that I didn't actually catch. It's kind of like a standard grunt, but it's got like a sort of Stormtrooper battalion sort of pauldron on top. Get my words out soon, but it just looked a little bit off, so I picked up these four. So we'll just grab these open, have a quick rundown before I go away for the actual review itself. So just rip this one open. They'll come in a little jiffy bag and desired accessories as well. So this one's got two pistols and a rotatory cannon. So just put those two there, and then he's got this sort of like a standard pauldron sort of arc trooper type on this one. This one, open up, it's kind of a bit like a grunt, I think, or maybe more like a captain. It's actually got a range finder on top of this one, two standard blasters and pistols, and plus a backpack as well. So looking pretty cool on that one, a little bit bent at the top there. This one, open this one up, and this one's got the standard blasters, as you can see, and I think this one is a standard grunt, like so. And then the last one is more of a sort of like a sharpshooter. He's got like a bazooka type cannon on this one. First time I've had this accessory, so I'll definitely have a look over that one. And then this one has got his rangefinder, binoculars and stuff on there as well. So we're going to go away, put them for the poses and paces, and then we'll see you in a moment. Away, we're taking their pictures, and what can I say about these four guys? Well, to be honest, we've reviewed many AliExpress clones on the channel, and there's no difference here apart from the cosmetic look of the green, which is really nice to have on the shelf, apart from the 212 and the 501st having a spot of green there. These guys, they did have an official clone trooper of these way back when in a four pack. However, if you wanted to go off and spend lots of money on that, that's up to you. I mean, you could be an in-box collector and not a bootleg collector at all. But if you're an out-of-box collector and want to play with your guys, then I think these ones are the way to go to get one of those 442nd clone troopers on the shelf. That is for sure. But yeah, there's a few little nitpicks that we can go through as we go through the review itself. But apart from that, yeah, these guys are pretty cool. So first of all, we'll start with the grunt, and we'll go through all their accessories. We'll do a bit of sort of articulation with this guy here, and then we'll do an overall kind of review as well with the figures at the end. So this guy, he comes with a DC rifle, same that we've always had, all in the black plastic there, and all these sort of details as there. So there's no surprise there. Comes with a DC carbine as well, again having a bit of a closer look on there, and good details on all that, so quite nice. Again, as I said before, these guys are about a percentage smaller than the Black Series, so they don't stand toe to toe with the actual Black Series. There's a small detail in sort of size, so these guns just feel a little bit too large for them in their hands. Taking that out, we can actually go on to the next guy as well. So that's the grunt. This one, I guess he's kind of like the arc trooper, maybe like a heavy kind of trooper here. He actually comes with a rotatory cannon, looking pretty cool. It's done in a sort of like a gunmetal, but a little bit lighter in the silver parts there. but the details on this look really nice. I feel like he hasn't got the new kind of clone mold holding these guns. They kind of need that sort of swivel up on the upper arm, but they still hold it quite nicely in their hands. Again, it's not done to the color scheme. This is supposed to be gold, probably black here, and more of like a bronzy color. So maybe one day we'll do a kind of tutorial on how to paint up these accessories, and as we go through and sort of upgrade your sort of clone troopers on there. But again, yeah, looking pretty cool considering Black Series don't even produce this. It's about the size of the 3.75 clone troopers from way back in 2010. So yeah, it is a good accessory. Next up, I guess this one's kind of like the sharpshooter. It comes with like a bazooka here, which I've never had before. And this is his only accessory that he comes with. So we can take this one off and look in a closer look. It's not too bad. It's done in a very sort of drab grey. Got some good details on there considering the Black Series don't make this one officially. However, the sort of like the hole at the end here, I kind of wish that was hollow. And then this bit here at the end is a little bit warped as well. So I need to put it under some hot water there to put it in place. But he holds it quite nicely in his hand. So you can actually bring this one right up. So if you want to do that, and then could you bring this hand over, bring his rangefinder down as well to get him in some sort of decent sort of aiming looks, which is pretty cool. And then last but no means least, I guess this is kind of more like the captain. This one comes with the most accessories. It comes with a DC rifle here. Again, exactly the same that we had before. A DC carbine, again, what we've had before. He comes with a DC little pistols down here as well in his holsters. And actually, so does this guy, which I kind of forgot. He's got little holsters down here with his DC pistols as well that you can take out of. And on the back, he's got his little backpack as well with this sort of... I guess Republic cog there on the back. Got these little kind of satchel parts, looks pretty cool. I really like the sort of like a sand texture of it. However, it's not a great fit. They always fall off on these, but you've got a nice little bit of storage there if you wanted to chuck in some thermal detonators and such on there. And this is removable as well. You can actually pull it off his back if you want to do that. Actually, I'll show that off because I kind of like the way that they've done it. So we take the gun out, and what you do, you just pop it off one side. There's no sort of like clip to get these off, you know, like you can't sort of ping off one side. You've got to actually take it off like a backpack, which is a little bit hard once it's on because the armor's always in place. So what I do, I'm just going to pause it and then we come back. So yeah, as you take it off, just on the inside there is a small little dent you can see, which is good because when you put it on there, it's got just enough room, so it's not just going to fall on there and sort of stick up the back. It's got enough room to plug in that little grey bit area where it doesn't shoot off across the table. So when you actually plug it in and the straps are over, it lays flush as well, which is a really nice kind of look on there. And you've got a little thermal detonator as well stuck to the bottom, which is nice. So with that, we can actually go through there. Articulation, so we just bring back up the grunt because he's like more of a standard kind of type here. So head wise he can turn left, he can turn right, look down and look up. He's got lower neck movement and you've got upper neck movement as well on there. Got full rotation around at the arm and it comes up to this far once you can put that over the top. And it's got a nice butterfly joint in there. No sort of new swivel or anything up on this part here, but we've got the swivel at the elbow and it's on a 90 degree bend. Rotation at the wrist and it's also on a hinge. Waist, left, right, crunch forward, back, tilt as well on there. Legs come up this far, forward, back, upper thigh rotation there. Got lower knee movement down here and it's more on the 90 as well at the knee. And then you've got the rocket and the pivot at the ankle. So all in all, good articulation there. It's not on the new buck as yet. I don't know if they're going to upgrade these guys. They probably won't. I would imagine that this is what it is. And then later down the line, they'll start bringing out the new kind of other kind of battalions on the new body, hopefully, as they go along. So before we go into all of the other kind of figures on there, we'll go through this grunt as well because they share all exactly the same body. So looking at the helmet on this one, really nice sort of details. We've got the black trim, that nice bright green as well. There's no kind of color bleed or anything on there. It's very much a reminiscence of the 212th battalion look as well. So we've got the nice sort of blue grooves, got the silver tips and the bits are on there, and the grooves, grey on the side up on the top, and the black on the bit on here. Coming down, you can see that asymmetrical kind of look on there, which does annoy me because the official one did that. But yeah, on the front, it's not too kind of like revealing in those kind of ways. But yeah, I kind of wish that was kind of symmetrical on that. It does really bug me, being a bit OCD. Got the green on the top, got the green on the side. You can see that they've kind of done some factory chipping as well along on the green there. Coming down to his larger fires, and they've got the green part there on the cod part, and then a green around on these sides. So yeah, pretty nice, really nice sort of looking green. It's not too in your face, but it's nice and bright to give that variety on the shelf. So we put this one down, and next up we'll go for the ARC Trooper. So again, he's pretty much exactly the same as the other guy. So he's got a standard helmet on this part here, but he has got the battalion pauldron around on here. The green is slightly off. It's more of a matte kind of green. This is kind of more of a lime, kind of going into the pastel type sort of parts there. The black is quite nice, and then we've got the kind of extra parts down on the side here and coming around the side. This guy obviously has his holsters on the belt as well, so they were attached as well. So that's his difference on that part. And then we have the Sharp Shooter. Again, this one only difference between the Grunt is that he comes with this rangefinder part. So this is actually movable, comes up and down. Got the green, got all the right paintworks and stuff all on the side there. Black and the grey, which is really nice. So yeah, it's pretty cool. And then last but no means least, again exactly the same. This guy's got the holsters, and then we have the rangefinder at the top here. And again, he has the same helmet as the rangefinder guy, and I'll go through these sort of details a little bit in a second. This one's got a little kind of extra clip part on the side. You can see this big hole, so that's why these guys share the same helmet. It's because this one's got a hole on this side, and if you want, you can actually pull that plug out. It does reveal a hole, but I feel like it feels a little bit better rather than having a giant sort of like earing aid sort of sticking out the side of the head. I mean, you could use it as an antenna part on there, but it just looks a little bit odd. This guy as well, when I got him, his helmet seemed quite sort of wired and squished. I put a photo up. I don't know if you can really notice it, but when I got it, his chin was really protruding at the bottom. So I kind of heated it up, pushed it down over his head, and even the head part of the top was more kind of flatter than the rest. I still haven't really got it 100%, but it's definitely a lot better than it was. So this one's got the rangefinder at the top there, and that is movable as well. So they are the difference there. But also, what you could do with these figures, which is entirely up to you. So you got these three guys, four guys should I say. So we just get this one standing up, and then we've got this guy on this side as well. So these guys have only been in canon. They've not really been in the show or anything. They're not designed to be sort of named clones. So if you buy these, you're absolutely up to you what you want to do with them. Apart from the Grunt. The Grunt here, his helmet isn't removable. It is literally stuck into there. I've tried pulling it out and stuff, but it is actually glued in his head. However, we just put this guy to one side. These three, their helmets are removable quite easily. You just pull them off, and you got like these kind of little bits like so. So if you wanted your ARC Trooper to have the rangefinder and pop him out like so, you could make your guy look a bit like this, making him a little bit more souped up. And then you could just make this guy a standard Grunt. So then you've got two Grunts like so, and then a captain. Or if you wanted a Grunt with a standard helmet, or you wanted to swap these two around, so this one's got the sort of rangefinder on it, making him more kind of sort of like captain type, which looks pretty cool. And then you've got this one being the sharpshooter, and he's got his little extra pistols on there, so he's got a bazooka and up close sort of parts on there. And then you've got two Grunts. It's entirely up to you. So I kind of like that feeling where I can actually go away and make my own unit, or you can make them four units of what you'd like. So a Grunt, a sharpshooter, a captain, and an ARC Trooper. So they're a bit like a Bad Batch batch in the 422nd battalion. It's up to you. Your imagination is your choice. So I think I might keep these guys like this. I kind of like it. I might swap that helmet back with this one, and I kind of like two Grunts as well, so they got their army and stuff there. So you got like a captain and a sergeant or something like that. But yeah, it's entirely up to you. So would I recommend these guys? Yeah, I definitely would. That green really stands out and looks really nice. And there's not many issues apart from this one's helmet and the sort of bend in the bazooka of the sharpshooter. But yeah, what you get, they're bootlegs. So thank you so much for joining this one. Don't forget, you can comment down below, you can subscribe, you can ding the bell, follow me on Instagram, join the channel for 99p or 99 cents from wherever you're from in the world. And until next time, take care, and I'll see you soon. Bye.